Hello viewers, welcome to CSS World. In this video, we will study non-proliferation treaty, that is NPT. So here we go. First of all, introduction to this treaty. Keep in mind that non-proliferation treaty is also called as nuclear non-proliferation treaty. So never get confused in non-proliferation treaty and nuclear non-proliferation treaty. They both are the same thing. Proliferation means rapid increase. So non-proliferation means to stop that rapid increase. By attaching nuclear with this notion, then it becomes a treaty to stop the spread of nuclear devices and our nuclear material, which means to stop the increase or multiplication of nuclear. Now, what are the main pillars of NPT? This treaty is based on three pillars, or we can say that this treaty is aimed at following three functions. First one, it is an international treaty to prevent the spread of nuclear weapons and weapons technology, which means that being an international treaty, the main purpose of NPT is to stop the spread of nuclear worldwide. Second one, NPT is supposed to promote cooperation in peaceful uses of nuclear energy. As we know that nuclear energy is not only for destructive matters, rather it has number of peaceful uses as well. So if the countries want to use nuclear energy for peaceful matters, then the Nuclear Non-Proliferation Treaty is supposed to cooperate in this regard. This treaty is supposed to ensure that if a country has nuclear power, then it must use it for peaceful purpose only. Third function of Nuclear Non-Proliferation Treaty is disarmament of nuclear. This is the main goal of NPT, which means the broader purpose of this treaty is complete reduction of nuclear weapons from the world. These are the three main functions of NPT. Now the preamble of NPT. Preamble is basically an introductory part of a treaty or agreement. Preamble states purpose, aims, and justification of a treaty. So according to preamble of Nuclear Non-Proliferation Treaty, the NPT, non-nuclear weapons states, agree never to acquire nuclear weapons. And NPT nuclear weapon states, in exchange, agree to share the benefits of peaceful nuclear technology and to promote nuclear disarmament aimed at ultimate elimination of their nuclear arsenals. So, according to this preamble, the states who have signed the NPT and they don't have acquired the nuclear weapons yet will have to ensure under this treaty that they will never acquire the nuclear weapons. Whereas those signatories who already possess the nuclear weapons will have to share the benefits of peaceful nuclear technology and they will promote the disarmament to make the complete elimination of nuclear weapons possible. Characteristics of NPT. Non-Proliferation Treaty was signed on July 1, 1968 in New York. This treaty entered into force on March 5, 1970. It usually happens that treaties take some time to get into force after being signed. It happens because of the fact that all the treaties set a target that ratification of this treaty by this number of the states inevitable for effectiveness of the treaty. So NPT took 2 years to enter into force. NPT recognized 5 states as nuclear states. These states include US, UK, France, China, and Russia. These countries are also known as Big 5 and P5 countries. They are the permanent members of the Security Council of the United Nations. This treaty recognizes these 5 states as nuclear weapon states and rest all are considered as non-nuclear weapon states. So this treaty maintained that if any other state except the P5 will try to get the nuclear power, then sanctions will be imposed upon them. We can take Iran as an example, as it faced same sanctions in recent past. Non-signatories of NPT. Now we will see that what are those countries which did not sign the NPT and hence they are not party to this treaty. These are five countries including Pakistan, India, Israel, North Korea and South Sudan, which are non-signatories of NPT. India and Pakistan have nuclear weapons and they are not signatories of NPT. India and Pakistan did not have the nuclear weapons at the time of signing of NPT in 1968. But they both rejected the offer to sign NPT in tussle of each other and due to some other reservations they have on NPT. They both were in the struggle to get the nuclear power at that time. Later on, they achieved the goal in 1998. If they had signed the NPT, then they could not get this technology. Similarly, Israel is also believed to possess the nuclear weapons, but it is also not party to NPT. North Korea exited NPT in 1985, but it never followed the clauses of treaty and hence it declared its withdrawal from NPT in 2003. So North Korea is also not signatory of this treaty. South Sudan is world's latest country, which came into being in 2011, so it never joined NPT. So Pakistan, India, Israel, North Korea and South Sudan are not the signatories of NPT. However, almost 191 UN states are still adhered to NPT. Criticism on NPT. Years have been passed, but NPT failed in achieving its goal of disarmament. Thousands of nuclear weapons are still present in the contemporary world. So this treaty has failed in achieving the targets which are mentioned in its preamble. Secondly, it was said at the time of signing of NPT that P5 countries which already had nuclear weapons at that time will do efforts for complete elimination of nuclear weapons, but the treaty did not set any timeline for the nuclear weapons states to get rid of nuclear weapons. Thirdly, there is no deterrent for countries to stay in the treaty. NPT does not bound countries to stay. Instead, they can announce to leave the treaty anytime. We have example of North Korea, which entered into the treaty in 1985 upon its own wish and left in 2003 again upon its own desire. Fourthly, this treaty basically divided world between haves and have-nots. Those countries who had nuclear weapons at the time of signing of NPT are haves, and those who did not have the nuclear weapons at that time are have-nots. Five countries are haves and all the other are have-nots. This treaty is being considered as an effort of P5 countries to maintain their powerful existence in international arena by putting compulsion on all the other states not to attain the nuclear power. So in this way, NPT is still being criticized. This was all from today's lecture. Thanks for watching this video. Like, share, subscribe, and don't forget to press the bell icon for more videos. Goodbye.